We are here in the Sweetwater Conservancy, and I don't know if you can tell from my talking, but it's so cold. This is Africa, but it's cold. We're at the base of Mount Kenya, and so, yeah, it's cold. We brought our really warm Kilimanjaro climbing clothes on. I'm glad we did. It's gonna be fun though. We're looking for rhinos and lions and even chimpanzees. The only place of chimpanzees in all of Kenya. Here we go.
And the dust.
Great.
Spend it down. There's still enough of us. Pee-pee.
Shoot.
I got it on video.
I got the second one.
A lot of pee.
More coming. There's water dribbling also from the mouth. Like it's breathing. That's something really nice when you have that in the photo.
I'm gonna switch over to DX mode here. Get a little bit closer on that. It's amazing to me how quick everyone is to leave. I love how you stay.
Yeah, it's all, you know, it all depends with the guide. The clan don't know. So only a few know. Yeah. So if you don't know, then you just be tick 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 tick. Right on.
Buffalo.
Playing. We're getting the morning gym.
There they are. There are two of them. There they are. I can see them all. We're jumping on each other. And if you stand up, we'll be able to shoot them.
They're so young.
They're looking at us now. We're on the easy land.
Oh, is one coming back to the bush?
Yeah.
So thank you. Oh my goodness. Oh.
Look at the babies on the bush.
One over here. Let me get the other one.
Come on, guys. Get curious. Get curious. Come on.
Do they have a den over there, or is it just a space?
There's a den, there's a hole.
Oh, they actually have a den.
Yeah.
Oh. So what's going to prey on these pups?
Oh, very rare. Nearly nothing.
Really? Nothing would risk it, huh?
Yeah.
It's just too small of prey?
Or maybe a snake or something.
Uh-huh.
How many are there, five?
I think so. Oh, good photo right there. Good photo. Oh, very nice.
Vitu ni wawili wamekaa tu mbugani. Get the black rhino, it's going away.
Yeah, I got some photos of him.
Trying to make the attention. This is the bull. Oxpecker cleaning up. Going for a walk of a snack. Wendo nasimamia piga moja. Hapa mbele.
Running gazelle to escape the lions. But the lions are actually looking at over here, the warthogs. They're out there. And right here in front of me are rhinos. It's incredible. So we have our rhino right here, and then way off in the distance we have this amazing giraffe, but everyone's on alert. You can see this warthog running away. Why is everybody on alert? It's because of the lions right here. Right behind them, our gazelle.
very worried about the whole situation. Behind them were already some zebra. They saw this and they were concerned. So everyone's on high alert.
No, they don't see very well. They are very good in hearing.
That was cool with the giraffe in the background.
You can see an underdog.
Come on, I'm going to do it.
so there are no other animals where we are walking. So, when chimpanzees are very young, from 1 to 6 years, you can keep them as pets. But when they grow older, chimpanzees become very strong. They become wild. You cannot manage them. So what happens is that their owners kill them. Others put them in small permanent cages. Others just drive them into the forest and leave them alone. So what we do here, we are trying to give those chimpanzees that were kept as pets a second chance to live. So the fact that Kenya is not their natural habitat, we have to feed them. We have to give them a house to sleep. So most of the time, we take care of them.
What do they eat, chimpanzees, mostly?
Well, just like us, chimpanzees are omnivorous.
Oh.
They eat different types of vegetables. They will eat different types of fruits. They may as well eat meat. They can kill monkeys for food. They will eat rats, mice, termites too, and birds' eggs. So here, we feed them 3 times a day. In the mornings, of course, in the afternoon, and then in the evening, we feed them inside the house. And then they sleep in there. For those who are sick, we take care of them. And we give them the normal human medicine, because they are just like us. Of course, you can see that. This is a certificate. They are intelligent animals. And sometimes when they get bored, they try to climb over the fence. The fence is electric, and they use dry sticks like ladders. Others will use long sticks like pole vaults. And once that happens, we all come here. We stay in there until we wait for other instructions. If they stay like here for the whole day, well, I believe we'll brought our lunch here. But it doesn't happen all the time. Just when they are bored. When chimpanzees don't have anything to do, they try to escape. Others do some abnormal behavior, like biting their fingers, pulling their hairs. Others would eat their poops, you know. Others would do masturbation. But we have to give them some challenges and just to give them something to do.
I'm about to see our first couple here. How many chimps do you have here on site?
We have a total of 24.
Hello, Poco.
He is the oldest.
Old, yeah?
Yeah, the oldest chimpanzee in our sanctuary. He is 36 years old.
Wow.
And of course, they can live up to 60 years and above. Oh, don't be naughty, Shiga. Of course, it.
So he's just telling me like, okay, I perform some dance for you.
Uh-huh.
Give me some.
He's a male, mm-hmm. and he was one of our chimpanzees who was kept on a small cage for so long, for 9 years.
Oh, wow.
We had a businessman who had a workshop, and he wanted people to come to his business. So this guy used to be in that cage, he was displaying, and then Jane Goodall was informed about this. She said, oh, this is terrible, and of course, rescued this guy. So he's enjoying his life here and he's doing well.
Wow.
Only that he's going bald.
Yeah.
And a little bit blind.
Yeah, true.
Yeah, right.
He's suffering from cataract.
Yeah, yeah.
Just like us, yeah, they'll suffer from most of these diseases. Cataract, common cold. Okay, I'm having enough. So these guys will stay here until they die. You cannot take them back to where they come from. Because they don't have some survival skills, they don't know how to find food, they don't know how to build nests up on the trees. Well, it's a failure. And they are endangered species. We have 200,000 to 300,000 left in Africa.
Wow.
Wow. Wow.
And the next building is the son of his son. He's called Oscar. And Oscar is 19 years old. He used to be the boss of the group, but he lost it to another man. Dude, Chica. So they're very active. They're very active in the mornings.
Right.
And late in the afternoon.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
Like most animals.
Judy, sorry, don't have a mirror. That's actually when they need a grooming session.
Yeah.
You will find another. If we had another.
Of course. It, So it's just telling me, like, okay, I perform some dance for you. He's a male, mm-hmm. and he was one of our chimpanzees who was kept on a small cage for so long. What is it?
Giraffe leg.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's pretty
part
heavy.
Of it, yeah.
Yeah. It's very, very solid.
Okay. So, it's a half family. We have the bush pig and we have the warthog.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And this sheep has come. That's the lower jaw of a hippo. And this animal is a pleasant. And my kid is a killing and these are teasers. And this is an ostrich. Pleasant cagey.
Wow. Oh, wow. That's
very lovely. Right, yeah. Pleasant and cagey, yeah.
So interesting. Oh,
antelopes and gazelles.
Gazelles, okay.
Yeah.
We don't
have
kudu is one of them.
No, we don't have kudus,
Water buck, maybe water buck.
Conservation is said to contribute to save the genes from extinction, and they thought of bringing us back to the natural habitat of Africa, and they blocked for here, two males and two females. Two are left in Czech Republic, died, two in US, the latest to die was in US, two also died, and of the four which came here, we lost one, the only hopeful male. So it's like, now they're remaining only one very old male called Sudan, at an age of 43, and two females. And it's like, when they came here, we thought of breeding this in their natural way. It's like we failed. After we failed the natural way, we thought, okay, we have failed the natural way, let's go to artificial way. The artificial way also failed. So now, the only remaining option to go to IVF, and that's where we are heading. Intravitreal fertilization.
I can't think of any right now.
Okay. Okay then. May I ask you, what's the difference between black and white animals? I expected that from you guys. Know the difference?
Wait, their mouth.
Exactly. The mouth. Good one. No, yeah. So you knew that.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. The main difference between the two is just the shape of the mouth.
Yeah.
But Maku, this is our native rhino. White rhino is not native Kenyan. It was introduced here from southern part of Africa.
Yeah.
Our rhino is this one, and as you have said, it's just the shape of the mouth.
Mm-hmm.
And this is due to that white rhino is not indigenous ours. As I've told you, it came from South Africa, where we had the Afrikaners, the Dutch-speaking people. We used to call them white mouth rhinoceros. But in Dutch, to say white is like white in English.
Oh,
so
yeah,
the
yeah.
English people misheard the name. Instead of saying white, they called it white. Later, another rhino, the opposite of white, is black. But the difference is just the shape of the mouth, and this is due to their feeding habit. You find like this one has a pointy mouth, as you saw while feeding him.
Yes.
Pointy, adaptation of feeding on top. And that's the reason why it's have like a smaller head.